finally I got a chance to take the new 2-hour PTE exam. Hello everyone, this is Moni from PTE Magic. Welcome back to my channel. Finally, I got a chance to take the new 2-hour PTE exam. And perhaps you have already seen on my TikTok account that I scored 90 for each module. But yeah, firstly, I just wanted to say that me taking the test and getting 90 is not to show off that, yeah, I'm this good and show off my skills or anything like that. It's just to prove to you guys that whatever I'm teaching you, it's working, not only in Pearson's mock test but also in the real test. Because what's the point for me to show you tips and tricks if I haven't applied them in the real test? And secondly, in this video I'm going to talk a bit more about the test that I took last Friday and share some tips. First of all, I took the test in Kensington Center. It's a small center, so it felt less intimidating compared to other centers. The only minus is the actual keyboard. And in many centers, you might get a very old keyboard where, you know, like when you try to press the buttons, they get stuck. You have to be very careful because sometimes you might not be able to press the key and then the letter doesn't display on the screen, so you might miss a letter. So make sure that you always check whatever you've typed on the screen. When you first come in, you have to wear a mask, but then once the exam starts, the invigilator told everyone that we can remove the mask, which is great, I think. So this is the actual headset that I got in my exam room. You can see it here. It's Andrea Edu 455 USB. You can also get it online, and I think I did make a video on this headset at the beginning when we had to test our headset. I placed my microphone on the same level as my mouse, and then I started speaking. I was reading some random sentences on the screen, and then when I listened to myself again, then I could hear very clear plosive sounds coming out, you know, from me, like in the recording. So I'm like, okay, I need to change the position of the microphone. So what I did was I just moved my microphone a bit further down so that it's not too close to my nose to prevent breathing sounds. And once I did that and checked my recording again, then it was clear, and at least much better than it was before, and I could move on with my recording. So I do recommend you guys to check your microphone properly. With read aloud questions, what I noticed was that there were many sentences containing names, and at first you might freak out if you see like the names of the cities or names of like people that you have not seen before, and especially they are very long and difficult to read. Then don't panic, you know, just break them down. Follow the pronunciation rules, break them down into syllables. And when you break them into small syllables, then it's easier for you to pronounce. I remember that I did mispronounce 2 or 3 words, but instead of coming back and try to fix myself, I just moved on, because we need to maintain our fluency. And also, if you add extra words, it might affect your content. So if you make a mistake, just keep going.
Tissues are grouped together in the body to form organs. These include the brain, heart, lungs, kidneys, and liver. Each body organ has a specific shape and is made up of different types of tissue that work together. For example, the heart consists mainly of a specialized type of muscle tissue which contracts rhythmically to provide the heart's pumping action. Tissues are grouped together in the body to form organs. These include the brain, heart, lungs, kidneys, and liver. Each body organ has a specific shape and is made up of different types of tissue that work together. For example, The heart consists mainly of a specialized type of muscle tissue, which contracts rhythmically to provide the heart's pumping action. A study found that the research funded by the soft drinks industry has different results from research funded by other sources, and went on to suggest that they may have been biased by the research itself. The whole point of the scientific methods is to ensure the research results are not influenced by the source of funding. A study found that the research funded by the soft drinks industry had different results from A study found that the research funded by the soft drinks industry had different results from research funded by other sources, and went on to suggest that they may have been biased by the research itself. The whole point of the scientific methods is to ensure the research results are not influenced by the source of funding.
With the repeat sentence, I remember having 12 sentences, and I'm pretty sure I missed one of them. Okay, the other ones, I was quite confident, I think like maybe 100%. My personal tip is that instead of focusing on memorizing every single word, try to focus more on the meaning of the sentence. Try to break down the sentence into chunks, like the subject, the verb. I will try to make a video on this topic, on repeat sentence, so bear with me. But yeah, moving on to describe image or retail lectures, I did use our templates, the templates that I show you in my previous video. And with retail lecture, I got two questions, and in the first one, there was an image, and in the second one, there was a video. So don't let them distract you. You know, when retail lectures start, just pay attention to your notes and take notes instead of looking at the screen. Unless you have a poor listening skill, you can utilize the words that you see on the screen. For answer short questions, I think I missed one sentence, the last one, like the last question, and I said, I don't know. So I think I was a bit distracted at that point because I was contemplating on the answer of the previous question. So I missed that one, but it's okay. One incorrect question is not going to affect your exam significantly. Moving on to writing, I had to summarize written text. You have to be very careful with summarized written text because they do give points to your reading. Not only writing, but also reading. And considering that reading is getting more difficult, it's better for you to try your best to gain more points from summarized written text. I made a video on 10 most repeated essay questions, and I got the questions number one on work-life balance. So it took me like less than 15 minutes to write the whole essay using our templates. So yeah, please go back to that video and revise all 10 questions. You might get them in your exam. By the time that I was doing reading, it's already 1 hour. Like, I think, yeah, more than 1 hour. And I realized that I didn't have lunch prior to coming to the test room. So I was really hungry, and it kind of affected my performance because, you know, food normally fuels your brain. And when you're hungry, it's hard for you to concentrate, let alone, you know, solving some multiple choice questions. Always eat something before coming to the exam room. Maybe have something sweet too, because it makes your brain work faster. I find that the most difficult part was multiple choice questions, multiple answers, because it was a bit time consuming. You will need to use your skim and scan abilities a lot. But as I said before, MCQ questions are not as important as fill in the blanks questions. So prioritize fill in the blanks. Don't spend too much time on MCQ questions, okay? So time management is the key in reading. Always look at the time and how many questions you have left. Otherwise, some students end up missing like few reading questions and it can cost you another exam. As I already told you in my other video that fill in the blanks questions will be focusing more on grammar. And I got many questions related to verb forms. For example, choosing between the verbs of past perfect or past continuous, or like active or passive forms of the verbs. So look into them, revise your grammar knowledge. Between grammar and vocabulary, I think it's better that they focus more on grammar because they're trying to test your vocabulary. And if you don't know four of the words in the blanks, then it's harder for you to choose the answer. And finally, with listening, I don't think there's much difference compared to the old 3-hour test. I got only one summarized spoken text and it was an old question. I saw these questions before many times on City of Rome. You can look it up, it's an old question. If your aim is 79 plus, I highly recommend you to get at least 40 keywords. With representation, I just wanted to test if we could still use alternative words. So I deliberately added two extra words in each sentence. For example, if I was not sure if it's student or students, I added both of them to see if it makes any difference. And yeah, we still got 90, so I think it's fine. All right, so that's about my exam. And I also want to suggest you guys to check if you are a morning person or an evening person before booking the test, because for me personally, I don't like taking the test in the morning and I prefer in the afternoon because my cognitive abilities are working better in the afternoon. But for some people it might be morning, so don't just book the test at random time. Book the test at a certain time that you feel confident about your performance, about your cognitive abilities, so that you can do better in your exam. In my next video, I will show you another experiment in terms of the exam scoring distribution. So make sure that you subscribe to my channel. And if you have any comments or questions, please feel free to comment below. Thank you guys for watching, and I really hope that you pass your test soon.